This is the new Nokia Lumia 1020 smartphone. It's a Windows phone with a difference, and that difference is this 41 megapixel camera sensor that's housed on the back of it. So this case is also available with the Lumia, and what it does is it attaches to the bottom of the phone and allows a bit more grip on the side, so you're not trying to hold it like you would a usual phone, which can make for some unstable, shaky photos. We're going to see whether it improves the quality of snaps that we take today. The first camera feature on the Lumia 1020 we tested was its panorama mode, which works quite well. You get a few circles on the screen and you just trail your phone from circle to circle, and there's a line for you to follow, and then it all stitches together into a really clear, crisp picture. We took a variety of shots with the Lumia 1020 and they all turned out impressively. One thing that's worth mentioning about the Lumia 1020's 41 megapixel sensor is that it allows you to crop or reframe parts of the image so you get the best bits of a photo without having to lose any digital image quality. This could replace the need for a digital zoom, but the downside is that you're going to have to put up with larger file sizes. The Lumia 1020 produces two shots when you actually take a photo. There's a 5 megabytes photo and a 34 to 38 megabytes photo, so these could take up a lot of space on your phone if you're not careful, especially if you like having apps on there as well. So we've seen how the Lumia 1020 has performed on a bright autumn's day. One of the things you should know about the Lumia though is that its pixels are actually the same size as you'd find in the Samsung Galaxy S4. So the question stands, what's it like in low light?
In low light conditions, there was a lot of detail in the shots. One of the nice things about the Lumia 1020 is the Nokia Pro Cam app. Now this allows you to use manual controls when taking photos. These allow you to adjust things like ISO, white balance and exposure, giving you even more control over your shots.
So that was our first look at the Lumia 1020's camera, and on first impressions, well, it certainly seems to take a good photo. You have to fiddle around with its settings a little bit to get the right results, but when they do come out, they are certainly impressive. I think it takes better photos than the Samsung Galaxy S4, and I'll be really interested to see how it fares against the new iPhone. When we get the Lumia 1020 into our labs, it's going to be really interesting to see not only how it compares to phones like the new iPhone, but also compact cameras, because you might well consider getting this instead of getting a phone and having to shell out for a compact camera as well. All those results will be coming up soon, so stay tuned to which.co.uk/